So get this! An Australian news station flew a frickin' helicopter over the set of Shang Chi. And to whichever local news producer said, hey, let's try it, we all say thank you. Because finally, some MCU news. We've been so parched. And this is an awfully tall glass of water. It's amazing what we can get from this, although there's so much detail. It's an amazing set. I can't wait to break it down with you. It's amazing. By the way, you can, if you're a company, close the airspace above your property. In fact, you can't fly a drone over a Disney theme park, as some people recently found out. They're like, let's take a look and see what the Disney theme... Someone with a drone was like, let's see what the Disney theme parks look like closed. And law enforcement was like, I don't think so. So somebody on the Shang-Chi crew done messed up by not closing off the airspace over the set. But we benefited because we have an amazing aerial shot of an extensive physical set, which you don't really see these days with the impressive advancements of VFX. Like, who builds the set anymore? But I believe it's because of coronavirus, which we're going to discuss in this video. But this movie, Shang-Chi, is like the anti-Mandalorian. Also, it's funny because the Mandarin is the villain in Shang-Chi. Mandarin, Mandalorian. But anyway, of course, the Mandalorian is also from Disney. So they got the whole shooting spectrum covered, from extensive physical sets to, we never built anything, really. Now, shooting is obviously set to resume quite soon on Shang-Chi. In fact, a few weeks ago, one of you sent me some off-the-record photos. I don't want to get anyone in trouble, so I promised that I wouldn't show them to anybody. But some off-the-record photos from the indoor sets for Shang-Chi, because they're ramping those up as well. And they looked cool, but also, there wasn't too much. There was basically just like the interior of one room that was being built, perhaps in this very building. But there are coronavirus safety signs everywhere. Basically, they look like the ones that you see in the theme parks. Wear a mask, wash your hands, cough into your elbow, stuff like that. Now, as we know, and as I've reported myself, Shang-Chi is a tournament movie overseen by the Mandarin, inspired by Bruce Lee's iconic Enter the Dragon. Lee was Hollywood's first Asian superstar, so it's a really great parallel to, of course, draw with the Shang-Chi movie. Bruce Lee worked very hard to overcome Asian stereotypes in Hollywood, and director Destin Daniel Cretton says that is one of his main goals with Shang-Chi. You know, Destin Daniel Cretton has no experience even in a mid-range movie. At least Ryan Coogler had done Creed before he had done Black Panther. And so I was a little nervous about him. I felt that and I think it's probably true, that one of the reasons he got the job is because of his Brie Larson connection. Again, in Hollywood, it's all who you know. Not always, but it certainly helps. Although I have to say, seeing this set, he couldn't possibly mess this movie up. And maybe he's partially responsible for this amazing set. So I'm a lot less worried about this movie. I mean, it's amazing. It's like, it's a dream to shoot on this set. It's so freaking beautiful. So yes, Daniel Cretton wants to fight Asian stereotypes with this film. By the way, speaking of Bruce Lee, check out Danny Chan in the Ip Man series as Bruce Lee. He's a very good Bruce Lee. I wonder why he wasn't considered for this role. Although Marvel has a very specific checklist for who their actors are. And I do think Simu Liu fits it to a T. He checks all the boxes. He's very Disney Channel-y. I think he'll be great. But Danny Chan is an amazing Bruce Lee, especially his amazing alley fight in Ip Man 4. It's so, so good. He was so cool in that scene that I couldn't help but smile and sometimes laugh at how amazing he was. It was just so cool. You couldn't believe what you were seeing. So if they can have that in this movie, I'll be awfully impressed. Danny Chan has a cool factor, and so did Bruce Lee. Simu Liu seems more like a nice guy, so we'll see if he has that cool factor. Although, a nice guy is, you know, very, very Disney, so I can understand why they went in that direction. Also, you know what else might help Simu Liu? Some Bruce Lee-style classic costumes. I think he's probably going to don a few of them. And I really bet that he shows up in the yellow and black, like Uma Thurman so famously did in Kill Bill Volume 1. It's similar to Gal Gadot channeling Linda Carter on the set of Wonder Woman 1984 with some of her costume choices. So Shang-Chi will be very similar to everything else that has taken inspiration from Enter the Dragon, which is a lot. I mean, this looks like a lot of other sets as well. and one of those is Mortal Kombat, by the way, whose own live-action film was done filming before the coronavirus outbreak and is set to hit theaters in early 2021. And at this point, will substantially beat Shang-Chi to the punch, aka theaters. The longer it takes Shang-Chi to get rolling, I'm still not sure it's going to make that May release date. I think there's a very good chance they're going to shift all the release dates once more, which I actually think would work out for Marvel, as we've discussed. But yeah, I mean, it's good for Mortal Kombat because they'll get to not only be there first, but hopefully really ingrain themselves in the pop culture consciousness before Shang-Chi shows up. I mean, Shang-Chi should at least try and get a trailer out before Mortal Kombat. Whoever gets the mainstream audiences first visually, it's going to make a big difference. But anyway, the tournament setting is perfect for Hollywood's new coronavirus reality because it's basically one location for almost the entire movie. In fact, one has to wonder if Marvel always planned to build such an extensive physical set, or if they took this forced time out to rewrite the script so that filming could resume if they built a single expansive set where they could lock down the entire cast and crew, like Tyler Perry's Camp Coronavirus. So my guess is, as to the set, that the main building is where the Mandarin is based. I don't know if he lives there. I bet that's where his office is. And also where we have the tournament. It has nice high ceilings. It's going to look really cool. Imagine how cool the set, by the way, will look at night. And I love that balcony that goes around the whole building. I bet we have at least one conversation on that balcony and maybe an action sequence. I'm not sure, though, what that dome is over there in the corner, though. I don't think the tournament would take place in there if you have the major building in the middle, but I think maybe that could be a practice area. It's very beautiful, very nice set design. In fact, this whole thing looks a bit theme parky, right? I'm like, where's the gift shop in the restaurant? I'm so excited. I want to go in here. Is that main building the ride? Or a live show? It is a live show. I mean, this movie just perfectly makes a live show. You could have a cool martial arts demonstration. That's very, very cool. I mean, it creates a theme park experience itself. I mean, the MCU's style is very mainstream and commercial, which works for them. It works for them. And that's very much what we're seeing here. I mean, get ready, China Pavilion at Epcot. I think that's the obvious place to add this. Although, we are still waiting for Wakanda at Disney's Animal Kingdom. However, they didn't actually build Wakanda, whereas this set could, that's another reason to perhaps sink the money into building this, because you could break it down, ship it to Orlando or somewhere else, but I'm hoping Orlando, and, you know, rebuild it at the, you know, there's a lot of land behind Epcot. I can just plunk it down behind the China Pavilion, and we're ready to go. So that's one of the other reasons they might have been like, okay, we'll pay for this. Also, note that there are 10 larger buildings circling the main one, perhaps to draw from the 10 rings theme. Perhaps there are 10 fighters overall, each with their own cabin during the tournament. It's crazy to build all 10 of them. Under normal circumstances, you would never do that. You'd build one exterior and then a lot of interiors on a soundstage somewhere else. But I guess they're like, we ain't leaving, let's build all 10. Also, perhaps each one has a very, again, you could usually just build one and I'd switch it out for whoever's, now it's this cabin. Or maybe you'd build two cabins with slightly different layouts and they'd just substitute for each other. But maybe everyone's there for a long time and they do a lot of interior decorating, which I would not be opposed to because that would be really cool to see. I bet Simu Liu's Shang-Chi will visit many, if not all, the fighters, so we'd want to see the interior of their cabins and perhaps conspire with some. I've heard, by the way, as I also reported, that Fing Fang Foom will show up. So none of these cabins is Fing Fang Foom size. So maybe in the MCU, it's a man who turns into a kaiju-sized dragon, or maybe he just crashes the party. It's going to be, I'm starting to think this is going to be a real good movie. There are some other great scenes here for filming as well. There's a rock garden. Oh, it's beautiful. There looks like there's some farming as well. Is the Mandarin's compound self-sustainable? He might be evil, but he does have a small carbon footprint. Destin Daniel Cretton has said he does want to show that the Mandarin is a complex guy and not like a caricature villain. So maybe that's one of the things. And also, maybe there's a graveyard. I could see a couple areas here that might be a graveyard from past tournaments. This back area also looks like it could be used for training as well. It's too bad they won't have the distinct foliage of China, which is really stunning, but I don't think anybody can responsibly film in China right now, especially from another country. I mean, the Chinese film industry, of course, has no choice, but I don't know if anybody else would want to do that. And obviously, they're going to add Chinese backgrounds, backgrounds of the country of China in post because of those massive green screens. But there is a lone cherry tree, it looks like, on the property, and I'm curious who lives there. There are a lot of support staff buildings. It's very beautiful. But yeah, you could easily shoot an entire Enter the Dragon-style movie on this impressive set. So what do you think? Share your thoughts down below, subscribe today, and of course, as always, you can check out some more videos right now.